Right on in and take your seat. We sure would appreciate it tonight. And it's been a beautiful day today. Praise the Lord. I tell you, may you want to go out and dig your bucket of fish and worms and go fishing today, right, Geronimo? And I think it's supposed to be this way about all week. I've looked at the long range weather. I believe spring's going to come right in here. And I like the nice weather. Praise the Lord. I think Saturday and Sunday is supposed to be close to 80 degrees. And I'm tired of cold and snow, right, Brother Jones? But I'm glad to be in church tonight. Thank you for listening online tonight. We appreciate a whole lot. Got a lot of folks sick, a lot of folks in sick. Amen. That's the worst kind of sickness. It's worse than COVID. But we're glad that you're listening tonight. Praise the Lord for his goodness. And I'm glad to be alive tonight. I'm glad I'm breathing tonight. God's good to us, folks. I'll tell you, how many of you, when you got up this morning, you took time to thank God for letting you get out of the bed this morning? Praise the Lord. We take life for granted, don't we? Take life for granted. But I'll tell you, I enjoy every day. I had to go to the mountains yesterday for a little while. Went to see my brother. He's doing well. His wife's doing well. Got to see my son and my wife and got to eat supper. And boy, Ange had fixed a roast. And she took these peppers and put on hot peppers, Geronimo, and put on that roast and let it cook all day. And I'm going to tell you one thing. All you needed after eating that roast was a big bottle of anti-acid Rolaids. Amen? I know you're familiar with that. But it was a good day yesterday. It's a good day today. And it's going to be a good day tomorrow. Amen? Because God is going to take care of us tomorrow like he did today. I'm just excited about knowing the Lord and being saved. Spent most of the day here today with the Lord, and it's been a good day. Only one time my phone rang today. Isn't that a miracle of the Lord? Praise the Lord. But I still enjoy living, and I'm going to live the best I can, as life as full as I can, until the day God calls me home. Praise the Lord. But I'm going to pray. We'll have prayer requests here in just a little while. We're going to sing number 43. Song entitled, We're Marching to Zion. I like this song, folks. The best is yet to come. Amen. The best is yet to come. If you don't believe it is, if you'll take this Bible right here, turn to Revelation chapter 22. The best is yet to come. Praise the Lord. I'm excited about preaching tonight. I'm going to talk about prayer tonight. And God's good. Let's pray. Father, we love you. We thank you, Lord, for this good day. Thank you, Lord, for being so generous, so loving, so kind. Thank you, Lord, for these that have met here tonight. I pray you'll bless us. And then those listening at home tonight, Lord, several people called sick. I pray you'll bless them and help them to be well so we can be back here together on the Lord's day. Bless the singing tonight in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's stand together tonight. Stand excitingly tonight. Praise the Lord. You see Miss Jones get up, brother? I'm telling you, she's been eating barbecue. I mean, that protein. Praise the Lord. Everybody going to have to sing a little extra tonight. Don't have a whole lot of people in here tonight. Why don't you sing like you do in your car? Sing like you do in the shower. Isn't it amazing in the shower how good it sounds? Amen. And I want you to sing tonight, number 43, We're Marching to Zion.
Amen. Good afternoon, everybody. I want to thank God again for you being here. On page 43, we'll sing the first, second, and last verse, Marching to Zion.
And the
Christ. Be seated tonight. Oh, bless the Lord, folks. We're nearer home than we were yesterday. We're near home than was this time last Wednesday. The Lord could come just any day. Praise the Lord. Now, a lot of you don't believe that. A lot of you don't believe that. You hear that and you think that, but you don't really believe it. But he said, I'm going to come again. Can God lie? Say, no, preacher, God can't lie. No, God can't lie. God said it. Whether you believe it or not, he's going to come. Amen. All right, let me make just a couple of announcements. Pray for the Worleys tonight. Peyton's sick, and Madison's sick, and Vicky's sick. And I'm afraid they're going to make Brother J.D. sick. Amen. But pray for them, if you would, please. The Lord will help them and to be well. Brother Jones had a friend that passed away Tuesday night. Pray for the Parks family and the Jones family. No relation, of course, to Brother Jones. So pray for him. Just unexpectedly found him dead at home this morning. And let's pray about that, if you would, please. And then let's continue to pray for our country. It's a mess. And I'm telling you, we need to really pray about our country, praise the Lord. And we need to pray about us, amen. We need to pray we'll stay right with the Lord. Now, a few churches now are starting to plan some meetings. March the 14th and 15th, I think today's the 2nd, so that'd be 2 weeks from now. Brother Cox over at Trinity in Knoxville is having Tony Hudson. How many have heard Tony Hudson preach? You got to hear Tony Hudson preach. Amen. And I'd like to take that little green bus out there. I mean, Brother Dave, get that bus cranked up. And we'll go up and hear Tony Hudson and evangelist Rayton Puckett. Rayton Puckett was Brother Cox's pastor back in Virginia, West Virginia, years ago. And I think Rayton Puckett's 93 years old. You ought to go hear a 93-year-old man preach. Miss Godwin, you could still be called. Amen. And you're 94. And folks, it'd be a good time of fellowship. Most of the time, after the services up there, they have a place to go down to the gym. You can get some food. And several other meetings come. There's one in Salisbury at West Park coming up. About the same dates, Brother Fugate and a couple other people that I know will be there. And so we're getting ready to start having some meetings. I think people are kindly getting ready to take off. Amen. We're going to have some special things this year. And I think, well, Brother Hunter, y'all did a good job pouring your concrete out there last night. Who finished that? You did? Praise the Lord, Miss Hunter. You ought to take him out to eat. Praise the Lord. And, yeah, that's very, very good job out there. Poured the slab and the ramp will come down the side, and that's going to be good. Now, will y'all floor that thing, Brother Hunter, make it real smooth? Because I've got me one of them things you ride. What's it called, brother? Yeah, I want to put a rail on it. I want to run down the rail like them guys do. Well, I used to skate a whole lot, praise the Lord, but had to give that up. But good job. Then I, fellas, we need to get that old ceiling took out, fellowship hall over there in the kitchen part where it fell through there. And he did it again, and we couldn't match the stuff that's left. So Brother Charlie Myers went yesterday, bought brand new tile for it. It's in the fellowship hall. What about that? And so we'll get all that put in there. We could get Sister Rachel to put it in, and Brother Geronimo said if she'd put it in, he'd come watch her. Okay? And we need to get that stuff done. It's the Lord's house. It ain't supposed to look like a dump. And also, the motor's taken out of the unit up there, the air conditioner and all. Brother Parker came last night. He and Brother Dave took that motor out, and he'll be back tomorrow to put it in. So hopefully on the Lord's Day, the air will be, I hope we have to use air Sunday. Wouldn't that be good? That means it's warm and nice outside, and all that stuff's getting worked on. It's just a time of processing it, and people have a day job. Brother Ronnie been coming by the evening and helping us with that, and I appreciate it a big, big bunch. Amen. I'm going to take just a minute tonight, and just in case you have a prayer request, if you'll speak real loud, I'll listen to you, okay? If you prayer request anybody, raise your hand. I'll recognize it tonight. All right, Miss Hunter. Praise Pray for Morgan. That's all you know, Morgan. Okay, pray for Morgan. And all right, somebody else had their hand up, Miss Rachel.
Same request. Our daughter had a miscarriage today.
And her name?
Noelle.
Noelle. All right, another prayer, Miss Mills. Shelby Graham, she's on there already, but she has lung cancer. And she's got to start chemo and radiation, so pray for her. And she was one of our bus drivers. Pray for Shelby, if you would, please. God will just help her and give her grace. All right, anybody else tonight? Miss Berry? All right, Miss Berry has unspoken. Okay, pray about that. It's pretty serious. All right, and anybody else? Miss Rose? Oh, Miss Godwin? Pray for Miss Godwin's family. Boy, I tell you, I'd like to see that Barbara Haley get saved. I was picking on you, Miss Barbara. Praise the Lord. That's part of the family, right? And all right, anybody else? Anybody else tonight have prayer? Oh, Brother Geronimo. Oh, Rose. Her family and her brother. Pray for her family in the Bahamas, if you would please. Pray about her back, if you would please. The Lord will just touch and
also the
Christians in Ukraine. Oh, yeah, boy. That's a sad situation. Folks, people die without Christ. It's hell, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's the only place God's got to put you. But there's millions of people had to leave Ukraine. Oh, how we need to pray for them. I see some of those children, little children, leaving their homes, not knowing if they'll ever return, even alive. And we need to pray. Oh, Lord, help us to pray for all the people in Ukraine. Also, pray for all of our missionaries across the world. A lot of them live in countries or serve in countries. It's dangerous. And so pray for all of our missionaries. The Lord will bless them. I seen Miss Haley. Amen. 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 Praise the Lord. All right. I think that's about all the hands I see tonight. And I'm glad you come. Brother Jones, come back. Let's receive the offering tonight. 143. Blessed Assurance. 143 tonight.
Amen. Let us stand again, please, as we stand in our hymn books, page 143. We sing the first and last verse. Blessed Assurance, Jesus, man. Blessed Assurance. Jesus is man. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. A heir of salvation, purchased of God, a born of his spirit, a washed in his blood. Oh, this is my story. Oh, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Oh, this is my story. All is at rest. I and my Savior am happy and blessed. Oh, watching and waiting, looking above, filled with his goodness. Oh, this is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Oh, this is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
Father, we thank you, Lord, for this day, for blessing us and taking care of us, and bless the offering tonight. In Christ's name, amen. You may be seated. Thank you.
For great things he has done. So loved he the world, amen, and he gave us his son, who yielded his life as an atonement for sin. And thank God he opened the life gate that we all could go in. And that's why I say tonight, oh, what a savior, amen. Amen. Oh, what a savior.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Thank God for the cross of Calvary. Amen. Saves us from our sins, particularly me, amen.
Once I was straying, oh, in sin's dark valley, no hope within, good I see. Oh, they searched through heaven, and they found a Savior.
Take your phone and turn to Proverbs chapter 15. All right, and then turn the little thing to Facebook. All right, I don't know if I have it, if I don't have it. People start sending me this, so-and-so wants to be your friend on Facebook. They 3,000 people on there, and well, sure hang out their laundry, don't they? So anyway, that was funny. Take your Bible, turn to Proverbs 15. And somebody put on Facebook, somebody showed me recently, somebody said you don't have to be go to church to be a Christian. That person's better than God. That person's better than Jesus who said that. Here's what I'm saying. The Bible said on the Sabbath day the Lord was where? In the synagogue. If Jesus had to go and he saw the need to go, I think this person needs to, amen. And just people stupid, backslid, ignorant to the word of God and the things of God. I think that whole crowd probably needs to get saved. And since I got saved, I wanted to go to church, praise the Lord. And amen. Mel, was that little girl standing on her own up there tonight in the pew? I'm telling you what, she's growing up in a hurry tonight. Proverbs 15, 9-1 verse tonight. Proverbs 15, all righty, thank you for standing tonight. Oh, praise the Lord. Folks, listen closely tonight. And verse number 8 says, the sacrifice of the wicked is an abomination to the Lord. Now, look at the latter part of that verse is where I want to preach from tonight. But the prayer of the upright is his delight. The prayer of his upright is his delight. Lord, I ask you tonight to help us tonight. Lord, I don't know what it's going to take to shake this whole world back into the reality that, Lord, you're soon to come. How we need to prepare to meet you. I pray you'll bless us together tonight, those who are listening tonight. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. The reason that a lot of people don't pray, I personally feel, is because they don't feel like, even though when they pray, they're going to get an answer. Is that you? Now, I want to preach to you tonight on this subject, getting answers when we pray. I don't have all of my prayers answered, but I'm going to tell you, when I'm desperate, it's called desperation praying. When I am desperate, I pull out all stock and call on God from my heart, believing that God will hear me according to his will. Let me give you this tonight. Getting answers when we pray. Number one tonight, you've got to ask scripturally. God is not going to answer a prayer that is not scripturally. Psalms 145 and verse 18, the Bible said, the Lord is nigh unto all them that what? Call upon his name, to all that call upon him in truth. Amen. John, 1 John 5, verse number 14, the Bible says, and this is the confidence we have in him. If we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. Now, Lord is not going to answer anything that's not his will for your life. Amen. A lot of times, let me say, we ask the Lord for things that we know that we don't even need to ask the Lord about. Some things, let me say to us tonight, we just need to pray, do it God's way, and let the Lord take it from there. But God's not going to answer prayer anything that's foolish. Amen. If you're praying for somebody to die, I don't think the Lord is going to hear that. Amen. If you're praying for your preacher, I hope you'll pray. But God is not going to, but a lot of people does not ask the Lord scripturally. Amen. Now look up here at me. Don't be looking back and forth. Hey, I'm the cutest thing in the building tonight. You know, something missing right there. It's called amen. And right, come on, help me out, Brother Geronimo. And Brother Dave, help me out. Sound off loud back there. But hey, you got to ask scripturally, amen. Amen. Number two, ask repeatedly. Ask repeatedly. Amen. Matthew 7 and verse 7, 8, the Bible says, ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and you shall find it. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. He said here, he said, ask, and it shall what? Be given you. Seek, and ye shall find it. Hey, don't pray over things one time. I mean, hey, if you pray and God don't do something, go back and pray again. If God don't do something and you need answer to prayer, just go back and pray again and pray and pray and pray and pray and pray. If you just keep on praying, you'll probably get an answer. Amen. The Bible said in verse 8 of chapter 7, says, for everyone that asketh, receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth, and to him that knocketh it shall be open. Hey, I believe in prayer. I believe that God answers prayer. But hey, if I pray about something and pray about something and the answer don't come, I don't throw it aside. Amen. I just keep on praying in desperation, amen, begging and asking God to do it, amen. For everyone that asketh, receiveth, and he that seeketh, findeth, and to him that knocketh, it shall be opened, amen. Listen, I'm saved tonight because of the prayers of God's people. I said, I'm saved tonight because of the prayers of God's people. There was people that gathered and prayed all night for me before I knew Jesus Christ as my Savior. Amen. Now, most people can stay awake 3 minutes to pray. You know, the nights are longer than 3 minutes. Amen. 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 Number one, ask scripturally. Number two, ask repeatedly. If you're serious about it, you just need to keep asking God. How many have got kids? Raise your hand. How many have had a cookie jar at home? Had cookies in it. And your kids would come and say, Mama, Dad, could I have a cookie? Well, let me pray about it. But no cookie. Come back again. Can I have a cookie, please? Boy, please usually get you a cookie now, let me tell you, when you pray like that. And you just keep on, and the kids will say, and you'll say to them, if you don't get out of this house and go play and find something to do, I'm going to find you something to do. Hey, they just keep asking because eventually they know you're going to give them a cookie. You keep praying. You keep asking the Lord. You keep talking to God about these things, amen. And eventually God will get tired of you asking, and he just might deliver what you've been praying about, amen. Amen. Ask scripturally. Ask according to the Word of God. Number two, ask repeatedly. You know, Brother Geronimo, when you asked Rachel to marry you, she said, no, I ain't going to marry you. Couple of days later, honey, would you just marry me? I told you I ain't going to marry you. But look who's sitting with you tonight. Amen. Give it in, believe. Just ask and keep asking the Lord. Luke 18:1, the Bible said, and he spake a parable unto them that to this end, that men ought to pray and not to faint. Hey, if God don't do it, Keep asking. Keep asking. Don't faint. Don't quit. Keep asking. Keep asking. Keep asking. Amen. Even the rich man that died and went to hell, he was doing some real praying. Out of hell, wasn't he? Luke 16. And so ask scripture number one. Number two, ask repeatedly. And number three, ask boldly. Ask boldly. Hebrews 14, verse number 6, the Bible said, let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may what? Obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. I mean, just go to God with it. Don't play around. Don't just mumble. I mean, get a hold of God. But come, he said, therefore come boldly to the throne of grace. Hey, if it's urgent, you'll come to God. If you'll come boldly, God will help you, and God will probably answer your prayer. I've been praying for Brother Bill and Sister Carol Anderson. I've been praying for them. And they came back, moved back. They live right out here, a short distance from the church. A phone rang today. I answered the phone. Guess who it was? Bill Anderson. Carried on a good conversation with me over the telephone. When we met him a couple days ago, he didn't even hardly know who he was, where he was. And they've been on the prayer list. Somebody been praying for him. Amen. And we carried on a good conversation today. He said, I get mixed up on my phone, Brother Hunter. He said, I messed my phone up. See, folks, he's had two strokes, and now he has those seizures pretty often. And Brother Bill can't even stand on 2 feet. And so we had a good conversation. He said, come see me. I said, Bill, I'm going to come see you. Praise the Lord. And sometime this week, I'm going over there and see him. He's just in a good mood today. And so I believe prayer has something to do with that. Hey, there's some people that have gone boldly to the throne of grace on the behalf of those people, and God is going to help them. I believe that. I believe that. Next, number four tonight is ask believingly. Ask believingly. Matthew 21, verse 22, and all things whatsoever ye ask in prayer, believe, and the Bible says, ye shall what? Ye shall receive. You know the reason that God don't answer a lot of prayer? It's just a bunch of words to most people. You got to believe by faith. When I got saved that Sunday night, 1968, when I went to the altar and I prayed and asked God to save me, I believed that God would save me, and I believed that God was going to save me right then. And hey, God did save me right then. 1968, I got born into the family of God. I asked and I received. Isn't that good? I said, I asked and I received. And then the Bible says that we're to ask unitedly, okay? Matthew 18, 19, again, I send you that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven. Hey, you know what we need? We need to pray together. We need to unite together. Two or three of you, you, Bible says, where two are what? Are gathered together in his name. He said, I will what? Hey, you know what? Moms and dads, you ought to get together and pray. Church, we ought to get together and pray. Hey, we ought to agree and believe that God will answer prayer. Hey, we need prayer. We need help from God. We need for God to answer our prayer. We need to ask unitedly. Then number whatever's next tonight, ask obediently. 1 John 3, verse 22, and whatsoever we shall ask, we receive of him, because we what? Keep his commandments. We have to ask obediently. And do those things that are what? Pleasing in His sight. Live right. Do right. Go to church. Stay in church. Pray. Read your Bible. Win people to Christ. Talk to people about the Lord. Listen, we need to be obedient to the Lord. 1 John 3:22, I gave the scripture. Now here is why sometimes that God don't answer prayer. Number one, because of selfishness. God would answer more prayers for some folks if He thought He would get the glory when He answered it. James 4 and verse 3, the Bible says that you may consume it up on yourself. Now see, folks, it's not about you. And it's not that it makes you look great, but it makes God look great. But sometimes our selfishness hinders our prayer life. Sometimes the only reason we pray is because we're selfish and we want something and we want it now. And so that you may said, consume it up on yourself. That's James 4:3. And then here is why no prayer is answered, and I've said it, unbelief. When I had that stroke, and I was desperate, I'd watched Miss Beth. I watched Brother Holtzclaw for years in a wheelchair. I don't want to be in a wheelchair. And I begged God. I believed God. I've told you over and over again about this thing. But, buddy, first thing, I don't want to be in a wheelchair, first thing. Number two, I don't want my wife to have to diaper me. I don't want my wife to have to bathe me. I don't want my wife to have to feed me. I don't want my wife to have to hear me complain every 5 minutes. And I said, dear God, boy, I'll tell you, I believed that night that God would heal me. I've prayed sometimes, and I didn't believe God would do it. But boy, that Thursday night, or Friday morning at 2 o'clock, I felt like I touched heaven. And so God could get the glory. I feel that God let me feel the burning and the pain in that leg. And when that happened, the doctor wasn't in there doing nothing. But God was in there doing something. And I didn't want the doctor to get any glory for it, but I wanted the God of heaven to get glory. So God let me know, Brother Jones, it was Him that morning at 2 o'clock when God sent that fire burning through my leg. You know what? When I got out, my leg hadn't burned ever since. Amen? See, I believed that night, and I could just see my wife having to deal with a big old guy like me. I'm pretty big. I'm 5'8", and I weigh 180 pounds. And, you know, the scales are always wrong. I went to see my brother yesterday, and he and his wife. His wife's 80-some years old, and he said, I went and bought us a new set of scales for the house. Said I put them scales, them digital kind. He said I put them together, and he said my wife got on there, and she looked down, and she's tall. She's a tall lady. She waited on them numbers to come up. It said 135. She said, Laney, take them back. They ain't right. Amen. But I knew that God would help us and God would help me if I would just believe Him. Verse 22, the Bible says, of Mark 11, And Jesus answered and said unto them, have faith in God. Have faith in God. Oh, so why are prayers not answered? Selfishness. Number two, unbelief. And then, sin. Psalm 66:18, if I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord, what? Will not hear me. You remember when you threw a rock and hit your neighbor's dog and you've been out on outs ever since? Y'all been fussing and arguing back and forth. You won't speak to each other when you pull in a driveway. Open your mail and go ahead and read it there. I'll give you, okay? Sin. Psalms 34, verse 15 through 17. Verse 15 says, the eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous. And his ears are what? Open unto his cry. Verse 16 says, the face of the Lord is against them that do evil. Now get a hold of it. The face of the Lord is against them that do evil. God's against evil. Evil's something time when you're trying to hurt somebody else. Amen. So the face of the Lord is against them that do evil, to cut off remembrance of them from the earth. Verse 16 says, the righteous cry, and the Lord heareth and deliver them out of their cry. You know, I'm really not supposed to be alive tonight. Really not supposed to be alive tonight, according to man and doctors, but not according to God. So let me say to you, folks, it is so important that we keep our heart right with the Lord. It's a little quieter in here than I think it ought to be right now. I said sin. If I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. What happens when you don't pay your phone bill? That phone's used to talk to somebody else. But when they cut your phone off, how's your talking go? You don't get no answers, do you? But when we get something in our life that don't need to be there willfully, we all going to sin from time to time. But I'm talking about willfully. God's not going to hear you. And last of all, tonight, reason we don't get our prayers answered, number whatever tonight, it's called ingratitude. Philippians 4:6, be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be known unto who? Unto God. Ingratitude, unthankfulness, ingratitude. Now I know people say this, why does he keep telling about the Lord healing him? Because I'm grateful. I am grateful. Every day I am grateful to the Lord. The other night we helped Brother Anderson get from the car into the apartment that they live in now. And it's up on the third floor. Of course, nice elevators, beautiful place. And so I getting him out of the car. He's a pretty big guy. Just trying to get a man that's just totally limp out of a car and get him up, and get him in a wheelchair, and get him up to there, and then get him back out of that wheelchair, which is real low, and get him into his bed. You know what was going through my mind when I was doing all that stuff? This could have well been me. And I just keep talking about it, and I'm just going to keep talking about it because I want to show my gratitude toward God. the Lord. This morning, God touched you and healed you of cancer. Don't let a day go by if you have a chance to tell somebody that God touched you and God healed your body. Most people in the shape that you was in with that much cancer in the body, they've been in the grave a long time ago. But just keep telling it. Just be grateful. Be thankful. But boy, ingratitude. Hey, don't give the doctors more praise than you do Jesus. Don't give doctors more praise than you do for people who prayed for you that God would help you. Boy, I got some. I've had a terrible, heavy burden on my heart all day. One that God needs to intervene in. I just wish I knew what it was so I could get on Facebook and get people praying. You stay off Facebook. Leave my name off all that. Amen. You just go ahead and pray. That's what I need. But God just got to help in this situation. It's something I can't help. Nobody can. But God, this is going to have to be you. When God does something, I'm going to give him some praise. I'm talking about why we get our prayers answered and why we don't get our prayers answered. You know what this world needs more than anything in this world right now? Prayer. Prayer. Sometimes I don't sleep well at night. And I went to sleep last night listening to Jack Hiles preach back in 94. He was preaching Longview Baptist Temple in Texas. And boy, I just got my little thing, got my iPad, and I set it up on the bed. And boy, it brought back so many memories. This is in 94, and I happened to be at Longview at the Soul Winning Clinic in 94. Brother Hunter, was you there in 94? You remember when Brother Hiles came out and looked at Dr. Gray last night? He looked so young. And you know that place went wild. I mean, he could just breathe and that place went wild. But I'm saying, folks, we better get back to praying. We better start making sure that if things right in our life to where we can get an answer from God. And I believe that God answers prayer. I believe that God's going to answer prayer. And I'm trusting him. I'm trusting him. And I ain't going to tell everybody about my burden. I just want to be between me and the Lord. You just pray about it. I ain't going to make no big, you know what I'm trying to say? But when God answers this thing, when God straightens this mess out, I'll let you know about it. I'll be grateful. I'm believing God for a miracle. And it's going to take a miracle of the Lord. I'm not getting all depressed about it. I'm not going to get all down about it. I am just, Brother Jones, believing and trusting God. Hallelujah. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. I've seen God do some great things. I still believe God's in control. God's in charge. And God's going to do something. Quit talking about it all the time and start praying about it all the time. There's some things we need to keep secretly and privately, and it needs to be between you and the Lord. Hallelujah. I believe in God for a whole lot of things. Nothing wrong with that or the church. I'm trusting God for a whole lot of things. And I believe God still hears prayer. And I believe that God still answers prayer. So many things seems to break. You ever notice if at home when something breaks, everything breaks? Isn't it amazing when the washing machine goes out, the dryer goes out too? And then 2 days later, you go get something out of the refrigerator and it's done quit working. That's because all them appliances put in there at the same time. Amen? But let me say something. God knows what we need. Let's trust Him again. That ceiling in that fellowship hall has burdened me. That air conditioned thing tearing up, burdened. That's $700 motor and parts got to go back in that thing. Ain't counting the labor. That fellowship hall, I walk in that kitchen, I just want to fix it. And here Charlie Myers came yesterday with a brand new tile, paid for it. It's over there. All you got to do, men, is put it up. But let me say something to you. If you'll start believing God, I don't have time to pray. Well, you do. Cut the whining out and start praying. I don't know. God even knows me anymore, everything. He never answers no prayer. Well, I believe his ears are still open, but the wrong things may be coming out of your mouth, and the wrong things may be in your heart. If we have ever needed to pray, it's now. If you notice the gas pump prices lately, it's awful, isn't it? They say by May it's going to cost you $5 a gallon. So if you've got a truck or a vehicle that holds 20 gallons, 20 times 5 is how much? How much? That's $100. To fill your gas tank. But let me tell you, God owns all the oil. Under the ground in the United States of America, there's enough natural gas to last for 100 years. Of course, Biden will stop it. He'll cut the key line, the gas, Keystone fuel line. We had more oil. We had oil running out our ears. But let me tell you, I'm going to believe God. We made it through years ago. Amen. We was eating some, over to Red Ball, we was eating Chinese food Sunday after church. And I watched the owner. He waited on us, and, you know, I can't find no help either. The owner, he's working, and I got to remembering back, what year was it when gas went so high? What year was that, Brother Jones? You remember when gas went so high? It was rationing gas. You couldn't hardly get any gas. But what we did was, Brother Hostclaw had a niece who started making biodiesel. And we went to Winston-Salem, and she showed us how she took an old big hot water heater like you use at home and some things, and she started making she taught us how to make biodiesel. And if you go down behind the gym at one building back there, listen, if you didn't know what it was, you'd think it's a liquor still. It looked like a moonshine still. Big hot water heater and all them tanks back there and all them pipes running everywhere. But to make a long story short, we was talking about we took a barrel. We went to some of the business, the restaurants. We took barrels, and we labeled them all, and we asked them to give us their leftover cooking oil. And of course, we started making biodiesel. We kept them buses rolling on biodiesel. And you know, we get some over to Fish Place. We get some at McDonald's. And whatever was cooked in that oil, when them buses had come in out here unloading the exhaust pipe, it smelled like whatever kind of oil we had. Hey, we get something that smelled like fish. We had cats following buses in off interstate. Sometimes, honestly, it smelled like McDonald's French fries, that oil they cook in. And but we made it, didn't we? We kept running. We didn't miss a Sunday. We kept by old diesel M old bus. Brother Jones, them tailpipes on that thing, wasn't that old diesel smoke black? It was clean as a whistle, amen. Hey, we made that stuff. And we found a company down in the eastern part of the state, miles and miles. And a farmer was making all this stuff. And he got in trouble with the environmental people. And, of course, he had to close down. And we found out, and we went down and we hauled gallons and gallons. We had big tanks plumb full of that oil, amen, cooking oil. And so let me tell you, if God provided in, he's not dead, and God will provide again. Amen. Hey, folks, how would you like to have your prayers answered? Clean it all up. Get it all working. And get to praying. Get to praying. I pray for my children a lot. I've been praying for a while for Tim and Angie to find a church. King James. And they did. In fact, it relocated 4 minutes from their house. They go out and turn right on Pritchard Road and come down the stop sign. Right there it is. And then now they've already made Tim the music director. And most of you don't know my daughter-in-law, but she's very talented. She can play the organ. She can play the piano. So I wanted God to use them. And they told us last night, said, we sing in church together, the two of us, Sunday. But God won't do me for me. Yeah, God will do it for you. And God will do it for your children. Amen. Just don't beat them to death. Just let God take care of it while you pray. Does God answer prayer? He will, and he does. Now we're going to start pushing a little around here. I need your folks' help. I need you to pray about helping. That God commanded you to help, so you don't need me to pray about it. Yeah, pray about it. But on the 11th, we're going to have a little ladies' fellowship. Miss Barry be calling you. You ladies need to get together and fellowship. But then after y'all fellowship, then I'm setting it up for the men. I want you just have it all together. Somebody got to have a babysitter. I figure this stuff out. Somebody keep the kids while the ladies are here. Somebody keep the kids when the men are here. Amen. But we're going to fellowship. We're going to get fired up about soul winning. We're going to see some people saved. We're going to see some people saved. We're going to believe God's going to save some people. And we got to get going for Jesus. If we could just get everybody well at one time. I think some of you people on Facebook, you say, now we're going to be sick this week. Y'all be well. The next week, y'all be sick and I'll be well. No, it don't work that way. Some people get sick, can't control that. But let me say to you tonight, believe God again. Amen. Believe God again. Will you believe God again?
Yeah.
Will you believe God again? You believe it's the will of God that anybody perish and goes to hell? Raise your hand. He said it's not the will of God that any perish, but that all come and repent. See, you got God on you. Tell somebody about Christ. Win somebody to Christ. You've got God on your side. He only sent his son down from heaven to die for sinners. And you know if we get fired up about it and start winning people to Christ, that God's going to convict them and draw them by his power. And these people get saved. See, the devil's convinced us that there ain't no need to try anymore. Nobody wants to hear. A lot of them don't. But there's somebody that does want to hear. They're out there. But we're going to have to get up off of our backside and make it happen. We get our priorities so messed up sometimes. What's important and what's not important. And folks, one day when you stand before God, there's nothing any greater than hearing somebody come up to you and say, thank you for telling me about Christ. If you just find one and they get gloriously saved. They're going to tell their mother, their daddy, their brothers, their sisters, their neighbors, the people that were, and there'll be a whole crowd follow along behind them. I remember when we ran buses over off Brookshire Freeway, and there was a mobile home park over there, and we went in that thing, and that's where Brother Mike Mustin lived in there, my good friend, Brother Mike. And Raven Deese, Raven's in heaven now. Raven was telling me about Brother Mike. And so I went to see him, Brother Jones. And I had a little 68 Volkswagen, little white one. I was proud of that thing. Paid $536 for it. Out here where Blackstone shooting range is at on Independence, there used to be a little Volkswagen dealer set right there. It's called Henderson's Volkswagen. And they had an old used Volkswagen. I wanted that thing. The church said, if you'll find you a car, we'll buy it. I went out there and found that thing. Had the fenders bent on it. I mean, it was ragged. But I thought, that's the car I want right there. I can paint. I can fix that. And so I went in and I talked to the guy, and he said, well, I got somebody wanting it. And he said, the first one of you that's here in the morning with the money, it's a used dealer there across the street, he said, that's the one who'll get this old Volkswagen. I got up real early. What'd you do, preacher? I went out there before the doors ever opened, stood against it. I had the money. That guy wasn't going to get by me and get in there and give that money first. I believe God. But I had that little Volkswagen. I'd go up that hill, and I'd knock on that door. Long time he didn't answer that door. I kept going back. I kept going back. And one evening, I went over there. I pulled up, and about the time I pulled up to his mobile home, I didn't have to knock on the door. About the time I pulled up to the steps, he walked right out. He kind of kept walking as I was talking. And he said, oh, preacher, I got to go over here, and it's right up here off Moore's Chapel down behind Thrift Baptist Church. He said, I got to go pick up a motor hoist. He's driving a little green 64-54 pickup truck. And I said, if it's all right with you, I'll go with you. I thought, I done burnt my gas. I done been over here, and you're not getting away this time. And I jumped up in that old truck and rode down there with him. But he carried had a pistol on his side, and I thought, Lord, this had a beard, you could barely see his eyeballs. And I thought, I may get shot, blowed up here. But I told you that to tell you this. In that place over there at one time, because that one man, Brother Geronimo, we had 35 people coming out of that mobile home park. Because that one man, Chip Stowe, who's over the Fundamental Baptist Mission Board, Chip was in there. They just kept coming. I mean, it's just like a lake and the wall broke and the dam exploded. I mean, they just people coming. And then they had people coming. They had people coming because one person obeyed the Lord. Boy, I'll tell you, that crowd, brother, we started having revival. Our revival meetings would go 2 weeks, every night for 2 weeks. Now, this generation now, 2 hours, wipes them out. 2 weeks. And sometimes these preachers wouldn't get through till about 10:30. We had to put a tent up where the bus is sitting. We outgrew the chapel, had to put a tent up. Worst thing ever done when they moved out of that building, because them airplanes started coming over, and it just blew that meeting away. Devil used them airplanes from right here. But I'm going to tell you, folks, God ain't dead, and something can happen. But now, these folks, when they got saved, the whole world knew it. It wasn't a Sunday morning thing or a Sunday night. Buddy, those people got on fire for God. I was out here mowing the tractor this week, or the lawnmower. I mowed over the grass, picked up trash and just limbs and stuff, and so I took the Z-turn up here to wash it up. And I took it down there and started servicing it and greasing it and checking it out. And when I was over there washing that high pressure washing wheelhouse, old Brother Mustin put that in there. It's still running. Just one. If you'll just find you one and pray and ask God, God just save them and transform their life. And then let them shine that light out, and the whole world will come to watch them burn and shine for Christ. Just took one. Little old Faith Baptist Church over here, 4001 Nivens Road. That bunch of women that prayed for me when I got saved. I pray that place got lively. I wasn't trying to impress nobody. I just feel a touch of God and Holy Ghost move on. I just shout. Boy, them deacons didn't like me over there. They said, it won't last long. It wouldn't last long. He'll get over all this excitement. Most of them dead now, and I'm still here shouting. Amen. Hey! And wherever them deacons went, that's between them and the Lord. Amen. But I'm trying to tell you, folks, the God that I serve, and I'm closing here, the God that I serve is real. And the God that I serve is alive and well. And we'll just keep on trusting and keep on trusting the Lord. Father, I pray in the blessed name of our Lord, you'll help us to pray. I ask you, Lord, to help us. Help us, Lord. Give us that fresh burden to pray again. Give us that faith to believe, dear God, that you will do what you say. There's nothing too hard for the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Oh, dear God, tonight, help us to find us a place to pray. And help us to find a way that we know to pray that we'll get our prayers answered. And I ask you, Lord, to bless all them tonight that's sick. I pray tonight for the Anderson family. I pray, God, that you'll help them. Pray for Bobby Cody tonight. Sister Rose and her request of prayer tonight. And help her, Lord, and touch her in the host clause. And, Lord, all these men and troops fighting in Ukraine, Lord, I pray for protection for them. And then, Lord, for Miss Alice, Lord, I pray she'll be well from her surgery and help her to be back in the house of the Lord. And then, Lord, I pray for Belinda Spry, Charles Hampton's dad. Lord, he's doing better, and we thank you, Lord, that you're helping him. And then, Lord, I pray for all the children in America. Lord, I pray for Nora and Laura Blankenship. Help them, Lord, to surrender. And, Lord, just give everything to you. And Brother Klontz got to have some surgery, a pacemaker put in. I pray for Brother Steve. Pray for Sister Anna. She'll have some surgery later on. We pray, God, you'll just touch their bodies and help them. And then the Strickland family, I pray for them, for Joe, and for all that family. Then Miss Gurley, I pray for Jean. And then, Lord, as we just mentioned tonight, Shelby Graham, Lord, has lung cancer, getting ready to do chemo and radiation. And I pray, dear Lord, you'll help her. All the other requests tonight, I pray, God, you'll answer and hear all the prayers according to your will in Jesus' name.